Please make your way down.
I'm still here as a struggling reader. I was told that I wouldn't be good at anything, but I use that as fuel. Each day I come in this kitchen to learn.
Here we go, top 13. Top 13, and I'm feeling good. Another chance to fight for immunity, and I want it. Immunity is the first step to getting me to top 10.
Welcome. We are halfway to the finale.
Yes, Chef. Yes.
You should feel lucky to have made it this far, because this has been the most exciting, the most unpredictable, and the most epic season ever. Sarah, top 13, where do you see yourself going?
Next step's top 10, and all the way to the finale. Mm-hmm.
Fred, because you've gained immunity across the last few weeks, it's almost like we haven't seen you cook enough.
Yes,
are you ready to get your hands dirty?
I'm absolutely ready. I'm excited for whatever today holds. I can't wait to show you guys more of my story and who I am on a plate.
Everybody ready to find out what's in store tonight?
Yes, Chef! Yes,
this next challenge is a true monster.
I'm scared.
Tonight is all about immunity. Win this upcoming challenge, and you'll be safe from tomorrow's elimination.
Let's get this going. Tonight, we have a huge guest. This guy's a multi-mission star restaurateur, an expert in Japanese cuisine.
Ooh.
And one of the most exciting chefs to grace any kitchen on the planet.
Oh my God.
Please welcome Chef Morimoto.
Oh! Oh my God! Oh my God!
Wow!
Morimoto, the Iron Chef, one of the titans in the culinary world. I'm completely starstruck. I'm a huge fan of Morimoto-sama. I can't even believe he's standing in front of me right now. It's insane.
Good job.
Oh my God.
Chef, welcome to the MasterChef kitchen. It's taken us 10 years to get you here, but thankfully, you're here now.
10 years.
10 years. Congratulations on the success.
Thank you, thank you.
Guess what? Chef Morimoto has brought in these beautiful, humongous...
King crab.
King crab, Alaskan king crab.
King.
Now, these crabs were plucked out of that pristine waters across Alaska and flown here. And tonight, all of you are going to have to turn this Alaskan king crab into something truly magical and break them down yourselves.
Oh, Lord. If I mess this up in front of Chef Morimoto, that's embarrassing.
Now, the good news is Chef Morimoto and I are going to show you how.
Oh, wow.
Unreal. Thank you. Wow.
I'm not crying.
Being blessed to be in the presence of somebody you look up to like that is overwhelming.
It's unbelievable. It's unreal.
Right, first things first, Alaskan king crab. It is the Rolls Royce of the sea. But most important thing is to make sure we get a maximum yield on all the crab coming out. How old do you think this is?
They're less than 15 years old.
15 years old, guys, okay? Pull off the legs first. One, two, and you pull and twist as well.
Yeah.
Three, and one big claw. Good. And wow. Twist, beautiful.
Wow.
Oh, twist, and pull.
Wow.
If you're careful. So you do not tug it too hard, just twist and pull. And then from there, you just slide that off. There's filament there. We do not want to see that, right?
This is easy. I think you can use anything, don't hesitate there.
Take the scissors as well, both sides.
Take this, it's easier.
A crab like this, we're looking at around $500
wow.
cost.
Wow.
Wow.
So think of the yield, okay?
I'm going to use a knife, fast move.
Gotcha.
Like this. This is easier. Then take, open it.
Nice.
Then easy.
Anyone dive for crabs?
I mean, I catch them every day, but not like this. And we use them for bait, which you wouldn't do for this either.
Oh, really?
I'm making sure that I can do everything exactly like he does it and exactly like he does it. I'm stoked to be watching them, but at the same time, I got to focus on what they're doing.
Never smash the shell. What happens when you smash the shell?
Shelling.
You get bits of shell throughout the crab. Open up, thumb underneath again, and lift. Look at that.
Wow.
Okay, now, let's be honest. It's the kind of crab that's almost like caviar. It's for finishing dishes. You don't put this in a crab cake. Understood?
Yes. Yes.
Never. So understand what you're dealing with here. And you slice the claw on, twist,
wow.
And snap.
Wow.
Pops off.
Oh, wow.
Finger comes in underneath.
Wow.
Come in. Yeah. You come down. Now for the exciting part, putting the most amazing jigsaw together.
It's like Pablo Picasso painting. There's so much mess, yet there's so much beauty, and you start to see this picture being formed. And at the end, you have this perfectly broke down, beautiful king crab.
That is how two master chefs break down an Alaskan king crab.
Oh my God.
Amazing. Amazing.
Outstanding. Thank y'all so much. This protein that I know so little about, because being deathly allergic, I stay away from it like the bubonic plague.
All right, everyone, please come and grab a crab and head to your stations. Come on.
They're heavy.
Be careful, they'll poke you.
I'm highly allergic to crustaceans, all of them. It's especially dangerous to work with king crab because they have so many prickly bits. I could puncture my hand and I'll start to break out in hives, I'll swell up. I just need to stay calm because if I get nervous, if I get scared, I'll fall to pieces and I can't do that.
Now, tonight you'll have 60 minutes to take your crab and turn it into a stunning dish. We want to see you honor that king crab. We want to honor Morimoto. Immunity from elimination is on the line. Right, your 60 minutes start now!
Yeah!
There's no real way you can mess up king crab except for trying to do too much to it. So I decided on making some king crab and butternut squash stuffed raviolis.
Flour, flour, flour.
I've actually never made raviolis before. I tried one time at home, failed miserably. I don't want them to think I'm just a fish guy. I want them to see me making something that they haven't seen me make yet.
Aha, they got squid ink, baby.
I really want to show the judges that even though I can't eat crustaceans, I can create a restaurant-level dish that they would love to serve in their own restaurants.
Extract that crab, everyone.
Unbelievable.
I know it's crazy with Chef Morimoto here, but I might try to pull off a king crab sushi burger. It's kind of like a craze right now in the US, and if Chef Morimoto likes it, then I think it's probably a done deal.
I'm making king crab saffron risotto. It's definitely intimidating a little bit cooking for Morimoto. They're taking it up a few notches this season.
I've never seen these contestants so excited. There's no better crab in the world.
You don't see it in restaurants very much because you have to charge so much for it. We don't want to see crab cakes. We don't want to see fried. You know, we want to keep it simple and pure.
What's the one big mistake you think they could make tonight with those crabs?
I don't want to see any, just the easy. I know what I mean.
The idea is that we want to push them, Chef. We want them to feature the crab and really lift up the creativity level.
Guys, we've got 10 minutes gone, 15 minutes remaining.
I'm cooking a Japanese-style entree. Really ambitious. There's a lot of components. I'm not technically, like, cooking anything aside from my pickle, so we'll see. This is a risk. But if Morimoto loves this dish, I think I can die happy.
Give a little insight to what you're doing.
I'm trying to push myself, Gordon. You know, I cook mostly Indian food.
Yes.
And so I'm going to go Japanese-inspired and, like, a really simple crab. Like a salad, almost.
That's good, but a salad is very small impact.
Yeah.
So you have to challenge my presentation.
It's going to be
beautiful. More leg and then crab shells, you know what I mean?
Oh my gosh, I have no idea how I would highlight that.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I can't say.
Take off.
Salad is very small impact.
Yeah.
So you have to challenge my presentation.
It's going
to
be beautiful.
More leg and then crab shells, you know what I mean?
Oh my gosh, I have no idea how I would highlight that.
I don't know. I can't say.
Take off.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Good luck.
I am making a pepperdale pasta with king crab. I make homemade pasta once in a blue moon, just for special occasions only. And being on MasterChef is a special occasion. So everyone's going to enjoy.
Fred, tonight is the night to shine.
Absolutely, Chef. I want to make sure that this dish speaks true to who I am and my Taiwanese roots and traditions. Because if I don't start showing them that I am telling my story through my food, they're going to cut me.
Give us an insight to this. What are you doing?
I'm making crab and creme fraiche stuffed lanterns, which are going to be my little raviolo.
So this is the meat from which part?
I'm using the knuckle meat and some of the leg meat from the smaller portions of the leg.
Uh-huh. So you're making a pasta?
Yes, I am.
And that's a lantern?
Yes.
So it's almost like you're taking a ravioli?
Yes, I'm actually going to take an Asian concept of a wonton soup and turn it European.
And how are you going to combine that inside that ravioli? What are you going to use to bring it together?
I'm going to use a tiny bit of creme fraiche. I'm going to season it with lemon zest, salt, pepper, and fennel pollen.
You never use this one anymore. Okay, so maybe you don't need this one.
You want that flavor coming out of those knuckles.
Absolutely, chef.
Sounds amazing. Good luck, okay?
Thank you, chef.
Cooking for one of my idols. I think Morimoto is in a league of his own, but I relish in pressure. To be able to give him a dish, let him taste it, I mean, are we kidding? It's season 10. I mean, it doesn't get better than this.
Oh boy, here we go.
Back home in New York, I love eating Chinese food from around the block or going to fine dining restaurants in Chinatown and tasting these Asian cuisines. I'm excited because this is where I'm the most comfortable.
So what do you got going on here, buddy?
So I'm gonna do a kimchi fried rice. I'm gonna fold the crab in and then also top it with crab.
What is gonna give that fried rice some flavor and some unique elements?
That's the green apple and lemon. I'm gonna fold that into the end. I'm gonna play with the toasted peppercorn. And even with the kimchi, I'm using rice wine vinegar to elevate the kimchi.
The one thing I'm concerned about is you have very aggressive flavors, fermented flavors, like oyster sauce, kimchi. Yeah,
strong.
Big flavors, and crab is very delicate and sweet. So just be mindful on how you add and season your rice.
I don't really eat crab anymore, but what I do know is rice. And I'm really excited to show the judges that I have grown from my first dish of rice till now.
This is season 10 of MasterChef. We're expecting nothing but the best from you, okay?
Yes, chef.
All right, good luck, Wuta.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Hi, chef. Hey. What an honor. Thank you so much for being here. I've been watching with my family, man, for 20 years. I mean, what a crazy show, but I'm just speechless.
What's the dish?
Okay, so we're gonna be doing a gazpacho with summer orange tomatoes. I thought the color was beautiful, so I did a lot of the orange. Put some cucumber, cayenne, salt, pepper, apple cider vinegar, and
I puree.
Crab in it? What's no there? Crab in that.
No crab in
no it? Crab, not, yeah, no crab,
no Noah's allergic to crab.
Definitely allergic to shellfish. Yeah, I can't taste it at all. No, I
don't. That's right, you can trust it.
I can trust, absolutely. This is one of the greatest ingredients, if not the greatest ingredients I've ever had.
Put that stuff in there at the end. It's gotta be almost like a sauce, otherwise you don't, it's gonna water that down.
I'll see, if it's not good enough, I'll leave it off, because that's one thing you've taught me. If it's not good enough, definitely to leave it off.
I am feeling so good. This is one of my favorite dish. This is a simple Cajun crab omelet with a Cajun crawfish etouffee sauce. I'm going to show them how an omelet can be very, very elevated as well.
An amazing bunch of exciting dishes. Looks like Renee's making the most amazing pasta there.
You know, and that's a traditional avenue to take, so we'll see how it comes out.
Wuta fried rice.
He's a vegetarian, Wuta.
Yeah.
No, he's gonna put the crab in the fried rice.
How can a vegetarian taste it before cooking?
Yeah, it's salty already. It's sweet, it's salty, so they need to taste it before they start cooking.
And he's making wonton.
Fred, he's taking a turn on almost like a Taiwanese lantern. The flavor of that broth already looks amazing. 30 minutes gone, 30 minutes to go, guys. One stunning portion.
Oh, no.
The sushi burger isn't gonna work. The rice is too flimsy. I look up at the clock, it's 30 minutes left. I need to win immunity. And this sushi burger idea is too big a risk. I need to scrap it and move on. If I waver anymore, I'm gonna run out of time. Ah, I have no idea. The sushi burger isn't gonna work. If I waver anymore, I'm gonna run out of time. No idea. I've essentially put myself at a disadvantage by starting over. I'm normally more composed. I'm calm. I come in with a really strong plan. So I'm a bit all over the place, but you know, I just keep pushing. Chef,
what you got, Nick?
Joe? I started off trying to make a king crab sushi burger, but now I'm making basically butter poached king crab with lightly smoked sunchokes.
You have good components here. This has good flavor.
Thank you. That has
good flavor.
It had to pivot a little bit, but
here's the deal, Nick. In order to be a master chef, how you rebound and how you excel in these very difficult situations is going to speak volumes of you. Okay?
Yes.
So look at this as an opportunity. not an obstacle.
I will. Thank you, chef. Thank you very much, chef. I know if I set my mind to this, I'll finish all the components, I'll make a beautiful dish, but I'm a little worried that I might not finish in time.
...25 minutes to go, guys.
What I'm concerned about, what I need to take my time doing, is making a dish with finesse and making sure that what I present is something that Chef Morimoto is gonna look at and say, this guy's respecting this crab.
Hey there.
Thanks for coming.
Give us an insight to the dish. What are you doing?
So I am doing a kind of rustic cut butternut squash. I'm trying to utilize this little reproductive flat meat. I know it's rich and it's a little bit different taste.
So what do you think of that, the muscle going in butternut squash?
That's not the much taste, you know, flavor come from.
Okay, so let's switch
you
up.
You can put them in.
Maybe a knuckle piece.
Knuckle piece, but just you flake it out. And
yes, sir.
You stick that inside.
Yes.
I mean, now I can taste the crab. Do you see what I'm saying?
Absolutely. Yeah?
Don't forget, touch of citron, a little bit of tarragon.
Yeah, okay, I'm actually going to do grapefruit, blood orange, and lemon zest.
Why is it even boiling water?
Boiling water?
We have these.
Oh, yeah.
Well thought of.
Thank you, Chef.
Remember, think in front.
I want to continue to put myself on a plate and the things that I grew up with, and I want to represent my family, and I want to represent my roots.
All right, so Dory.
Whatever it is, it's beautiful. What are those?
Those are fried green
tomatoes. Fried green tomatoes.
Love it.
Tomatoes.
My mom used to make these all the time, and as a mom myself, I've made them for my children.
So what else do you have going on your dish here?
Light crab salad. I want to keep the integrity of the crab. I don't want to do too much to it.
This is really good. Acidity.
Thank you.
You have something base or something creamy?
Yes, I do.
To moderate it,
yes,
what are you going to do?
Yeah, there you go. She's already on it. Look,
yeah,
don't even.
There we are.
What is this, spicy mayo?
It is.
Dorian, out there in Georgia, do you have a chance to get with. Hey, take it ish. You have a chance.
You can eat all you want here. You want me to feed it to you? You can have all you want.
Do you work with a lot of king crab back home?
No, I do not. My husband and I go to a restaurant that serves king crab, and I was pregnant, and I sat down and ate like 6 whole legs. But I mean, other than that, no, it's a delicacy. I mean, it's expensive.
This, for someone who's never cooked it, this is a really great interpretation of the delicacy, really with balanced acidity. Love it.
Oh, thank you.
Sam.
Chef Morimoto, it's an honor. So I'm doing a crab and corn chowder. This is a fish stock, chef, that I cooked down with some fennel and some king crab legs.
Yeah. Great. It tastes okay, but it doesn't taste like king crab. So you need strength in there. These little bits here, you get in there.
Understood, chef. I really want to prove myself.
Yeah. I mean, on a night like tonight, in front of chef here?
Absolutely. This is a dream for me. Want this, chef.
You've got 15 minutes to go,
Thank you so much, chef. Absolutely,
please.
Chef. This is my most challenging one yet, because I don't know how a king crab tastes. I don't know how any crab tastes. So I really need to use my knowledge of flavors and herbs and really put together something that's going to work.
I just want to say, this is mind-blowing. Standing in front of you and Gordon at the same time, I couldn't have imagined anything crazier.
Give us the insight to the dish from you. Oh, wow.
This is squid ink tarragon risotto, and I'm going to be doing my crab in a Vermont sauce. And I have over here my lemon saffron aioli over top.
It's very rare you finish a risotto with aioli. Why are you going there?
It has lemon, it has the brightness of the saffron, it adds color to the plate.
Yeah,
it adds
you can pour that in the risotto.
Just drizzled lightly over top, chef, just to bring some flavor to the crab
but
as
make
well.
Make sure the risotto is rich, buttery,
nothing
no crab
crumbly,
in there.
No, sir, I'm allergic to shellfish.
But you cannot even taste it.
Can't taste it.
You should be flaking all those little knuckles in there as well, so you got crab in there as well.
Crab in there as well.
Okay, that tastes delicious.
Thank you, chef.
Guys, just under 7 minutes to go.
Dang it. My pasta is sticking to the roller, and I can't find a pasta cutter anywhere. So I hand cut with a knife, and they are wretched. I am feeling really frustrated right now. I'm a huge perfectionist, and if it's not going to work out, then I just throw it away.
So this is going to be your white wine sauce?
Yes, sir.
Where are the pappardelle?
Those are the ones I'm going to cook.
These? This is not pasta. This is like scraps. Where's the rest of the pasta?
I threw it away. I was pissed.
You can't make a pasta with this.
I'm going to. Please, let me try.